Shalom. This is Levi Shor. Welcome back to Swing Good Torah. So we're going to learn amazing Parsha, Parsha Shemini, all about the Shechinah entering the Mishkan for the first time on Rosh Chodesh Nissan, on the first of the month of Nissan, on the eighth day of the Meluim, of the inauguration of the Mishkan. So it's an incredible fact that there's only one nation in the world that the Shechinah has lived with. So what is the Shechinah? So it's a very complicated topic, and I tell you honestly, I don't fully understand it. It's very esoteric. It goes very much into the Nistar, the hidden parts of the Torah, but it is, in essence, a physical manifestation of Hashem. So what does that mean exactly? The physical manifestation of an infinite being in this physical world? Very complicated, but it's incredible. So all throughout the history of the world, the Shekhinah, so on this day of Rosh Chodesh Nissan, the first of Nissan, 2449, 1 year after 2448, which was the famous year of Yetzias Mitzrayim, when we left Egypt, when we left the slavery in Egypt, Jewish people, they completed the Mishkan. And first, for the first 7 days, Moshe Rabbeinu, Moses, set up the Mishkan, and he brought the korbanos in the Mishkan, and he took it down every day. And then it was set up again on the eighth day, and then Moshe told Aaron a Kohen, his brother Aaron, that he would be the Kohen Gadol, that he would now be the high priest, that he and his sons would start bringing the korbanos, the offerings in the Mishkan. And on this day, we saw the Shekhinah of Hashem actually enter into the Mishkan. So we'll talk about when do we first see the Shekhinah in our history, but a little fact that's very interesting. So the children of Esav and the children of Ishmael, they claim that Hashem has forsaken the Jewish people and he has now chosen them and they are the new chosen people. But an interesting fact, the Shekhinah has only revealed itself living with the Jewish people. So even in the height of the Roman Empire, you know, even in the days of Julius Caesar and Augustus, and even in the golden age of the Roman Empire, during Emperor Marcus Aurelius Antoninus, the Shekhinah did not live in Rome. And the Shekhinah never appeared in Mecca. And at the height of the British Empire, during the reigns of Queen Victoria and this current reign of Queen Elizabeth, the Shekhinah never lived in London. And even during the reigns of Charlemagne and Napoleon in France, the Shekhinah never revealed itself in Paris. And even in the great presidents of the United States of America, from George Washington into Donald Trump now, the Shekhinah has never lived in Washington, D.C. So only one nation has the Shekhinah revealed itself and lived with us. And in our exile, the Shekhinah also hides itself. So we see something fascinating during the second temple, the second Beis Hamikdash, where King Yoshiah hid the Arna Kodesh, he hid the Ark of the Covenant, and we didn't have the Ark of the Covenant in the second temple, and the Shekhinah did not go into the temple during the second temple. And that's why, even though it was, even during the empires of Persia and the empires and the Greek Empire, and there's many Jews still living in Eretz Yisrael, it's still called the Gullus Paras and the Gullus Yavan, the exile of Persia and the exile of Greece, because the Shekhinah wasn't living with us at that time. And it'll only be Bezrat Hashem when the coming of Mashiach, and we'll see the return of the Shekhinah when the third Beis HaMikdash is rebuilt. But what's so fascinating is, so when did the Shekhinah first reveal itself to the Jewish people? So as a simple shepherd, and he was chasing after a lost sheep that went into the Midbar of Sinai. And that was Moses, of course, Moshe Rabbeinu. And he chased after this little sheep, and he came to the foot of Har Sinai, of Mount Sinai. And he saw on the mountain, he saw this tree, this little bush, and it was burning with a spiritual fire. And that was the first time the Shekhinah revealed itself to the Jewish people, to Moshe. And then Moshe was given the command to go and bring the Jewish people back to Har Sinai. So Moshe goes, Moses goes, to Egypt, and we just celebrated Pesach, we just celebrated Passover, we saw the miraculous, the Eser Makos, the 10 plagues that Hashem brought on Egypt, and then the Shekhinah is revealed to us as a nation when we're coming out of Egypt, when we're coming out of Pesach. Hashem revealed the Shekhinah inside, he wrapped it by day inside the pillar of cloud, and at night inside the pillar of fire, and it was leading us. And Hashem was leading us. He was revealing his Shekhinah and leading us out of Mitzrayim. And then we're in this period now, the Sefiras HaOmer, these 7 weeks, and we're purifying ourselves, we're working on our midos, we're improving our personal characteristics, we're refining our character, recounting the Omer every day for 49 days, 7 weeks, working on each midah of chesed. First we start with kindness, then gevura, strength, self-control, tiferes, the beautiful balance between them both, netzach, tapping into that, you know, eternal quality, victory, hod, empathy for others, and we balance that into the yesod, the balance of shalom bias, of a balance between peace, between people, between husband and wife, between friends. We get that yesod, and then we come into malchus, the royalty, the seventh week, the royalty, and it all comes together. And then we Hashem revealed once again the Shechinah, the top of Har Sinai on Shavuos, when the sixth of Sivan was burning with the spiritual fire again. We saw the Shekhinah on top of the mountain, and Hashem spoke to us from out of that fire, from out of His Shekhinah on top of that burning mountain. And then we slipped, and then we stumbled worse than we ever did in Jewish history, and we built the Chet HaEgel, the golden calf. And the other nations claim that Hashem abandoned us, but it's not true, because after all this, Hashem forgave us. And on Yom Kippur of that year, Moshe came down with the second luchos, the second set of sapphire tablets with the Ten Commandments written on it. And then, when that next Nissan, a year later, on Rosh Chodesh Nissan, on the first of Nissan, on the eighth day, the Shekhinah came in the Kodesh HaKadoshim, the Holy of the Holies, on top of the Arna Kodesh, on top of the Ark of the Covenant. And the Shekhinah began to live with us as a nation. And Bizrat Hashem, the Shekhinah was with us for the 40 years, all throughout the wandering in the desert. And it came into Eretz Yisrael, into the land of Israel for us, all through the period of the Shoftim. And then finally, David HaMelech, King David, he began to get the materials together to build a permanent house, to build the first base on Mikdash. And his son, Shlomo HaMelech, King Solomon, builds the first temple, and the Shekhinah comes back in to live with us. And in Bizrat Hashem, we will see the coming of Mashiach soon, and we'll see the return of the Shekhinah to Yerushalayim, to Jerusalem, to the Har HaBayis, in back into the Kodesh HaKadoshim, where we will find again the Arna Kodesh, we will find Raiders of the Lost Ark, we will find the Ark of the Covenant, and we'll see Bizrat Hashem, the Shekhinah return, and it will be eternal now, it will be forever. The Shekhinah will live in the Kodesh HaKadoshim among the Jewish people, not just in the Beis HaMikdash, in the hearts of all the Jewish people. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it. The incredible L'mayla min hateva, the supernatural qualities of Parsha Shemini, and I hope to see you back again soon on Sweet and Good Torah. Thank you.